From the dawn of time we came, moving silently down through the centuries. No one has ever known we were among you. Until now.
Listen to me, the day's coming, and it ain't gonna be long when you ain't even gonna have to leave your living room. No more schools, no more bodegas, no more tabernacles, no more cineplexes, all right? You're gonna snuggle up to your fiber optics, baby, and bliss out.
So nice of you to visit again.
The individual now, it's difficult for him to associate with anything, or with anybody or any institution.
Everything that we call human life is planned to be controlled by these psychopaths.
You already see what the plan is. It's endless lockdowns, it's endless lies.
The Second Amendment is my gun for a man.
Now you listen to me. You can't win this way. Follow the rules. Play the game. Be happy.
We don't have an American working class. There's been a Weimarization of the American working class.
What else you got?
No, what do you got?
Convicted pedophiles have erections and their boys and girls bounce as the old women squeal and get off. These women are demonic.
Who are you? You miserable, presumptuous, no talent. You're no artist.
What did you want to do to stop myself with an art? You wouldn't
be. If you want to know the future is the past.
Have a bloody courage to believe in yourself.
Yes, please. The girls are sexy.
Woo! They don't want you to think. I mean, these are the people running the country. And they're illiterate. They're illiterate in the real sense of the word. They're illiterate. And that's what they want. They want us to be illiterate. And they're doing a damn good job of it.
The law is one. There are no mistakes. I am Ra. I leave this instrument in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator. Adonai.
Just begun.
His fucking tongue, dude.
Just saying it's so matter of fact.
Whoa.
Yeah, things got hectic. Pretty much just for me. You're pretty much chilling. Well-oiled machine.
Are we on?
Yeah, we're back here.
Nighttime.
Obviously, dude. Always get so tired. But yeah, I mean, right now I'm just running off. I don't care about conspiracy theories. I don't care about anything, dude. We have a history. It's a great history. The pyramids were built. All these things pump me up so viciously. I don't care what's going on in the world. The fact that you, like, Egyptologists need to be murdered.
So fraud.
That's insanity.
Yeah, dude. And it's not even close. It's like a joke.
People say, like, oh, dude, pyramid shit. Like, dude, if you've done anything regarding heavy objects and you look at the pyramids and just go, yeah, I mean, dude, pulleys.
I was on a mini, what size is that? Small. Little thing. It was getting stopped by dirt.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's no fucking way. 20 tons, bro?
They're so heavy.
Yeah, no shit.
And there's like, you're telling me stones and copper is what's making that, dude?
Different styles of stone everywhere, buried. The bottom of the pyramids, like the bases of them.
Yeah.
All the bases of those, like, ancient places are all the same kind of megalithic shit that, like, you'd have to be a cyclops to pick up. Or you'd have to harness sound or talk to the infinite consciousness of stone.
Yeah, I mean, it all started this week because I watched that one I put up on the Patreon. And then from there, it was just game over. I was listening to all the Graham Hancock shit, all the ancient builder stuff. I watched a dude on YouTube channel the ancient builder race. It wasn't that fruitful, but it was funny.
Fuck yeah, dude.
It's just crazy how all that shit lines up and people just naysay it. Like, that is the coolest shit ever.
Yeah, it's my favorite thing to watch. That's like my porn. Like, you know, girls watch, like, the CSI or whatever, like the murder mysteries and stuff. Yeah. That's my version of that.
Yeah, it is weird though, because when I was watching it, like every single time, it just goes back to like people who want to give the truth and the light to people, and then people who want a fucking human sacrifice.
Yeah, there's also a whole other thing where like Saturn was our sun. That's a whole other thing. Where like all the planets came out of Saturn.
Yeah, I mean
that's fucking wild. They're also saying now they think Jupiter might be hollow. So NASA's like admitting a little bit to the fact that planets might be hollow.
Yeah, I mean,
pretty cool.
People shit on astrology, and I understand. It's fucking for thoughts.
You are a thought.
Maybe I'm a thought.
I mean, dude, if you were a girl, you would just be a thought.
Right now, I'm focusing on me. I don't think I'm that hoe over there, but I'm definitely focusing on me and taking some me time. But, I mean, astrology's been around for so fucking long, dude. There's something to it. They wouldn't have appointed the Sphinx looking at the stars like that if it was all bullshit.
Like, when you read this stuff, like, do you think you're a Scorpione?
What do you mean?
Like, when you read about yourself, when you read about your Scorpio, are you like, that's totally me?
Yeah, dude. November 1st, 1992. Dude, I'll forgive you, but I'll never forget, okay? Do you have a problem with that?
All right, hey, man. I mean, we're the two top guys.
Yeah, right now.
Bringing in the new age.
It is the age of Aquarius. Bro. This is for you. But, I mean, yeah, it was just chill watching that, and then we were just chilling down there trying to watch. We stepped back into reality.
That was sad. When I saw down there, I was sad.
We stepped back into reality.
You were sipping to fucking Zilla pretty bad.
Okay. I enjoyed Godzilla when I was younger, and it's free streaming. I'm not spending $20 on it like I did on The Mule. This is free streaming on HBO Max. Horrible fucking movie.
That's pretty bad, man.
I think
it's for kids, dude.
I don't know.
You might be outgrown in some of the movies that are made.
But you're watching, what's it called? What's the Star Wars stuff?
So anyway, I've been watching, I signed up for like a free trial on Peacock to watch the John Wayne Gacy thing. It's totally cool. It's about serial killers, totally grown up stuff.
It's
super manly. It's about this painting contractor that was like grabbing dudes and he was like wrestling with them and like fucking them and then burying them underneath his house. Crazy shit, dude. He used to have stag nights. He'd show young dudes porn. He'd be like, yo, man, you want to work with me? Like, why would I pay, like, this guy who's a painter? He's, like, in his 20s. Grab a teenager, dude.
Show him some porn.
Give him a van.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, dude.
I mean, yeah, just hilarious that you walk in all cock, like, give me some beers. And then you sit down and watching King Kong. And then you're like, this is for kids. This is for kids. What's the Star Wars thing called?
Yeah.
What is it called? Mandalorian. This is for kids, dude. You have Disney Plus. Throw in The Mandalorian. I know this is for kids.
Did you see the trailer for The Bad Batch? I mean, there's a whole new series coming out.
Is it really? They're probably going to fucking cancel it. Yeah, but that was
a spinoff of The Clone Wars.
Nice. It's
a good animated series.
Right on, dude. That's grown-up shit. It's grown man talk right now.
For real,
This
bro.
Is nighttime. This is grown man talk.
It's nighttime, dude. Let me crack open these studs.
Yeah, I mean, everything's going to shit. They ruined Godzilla. Little Nas X is making a shoe that is just like, you sent me that shit about this month being like the month of satanic sacrifice.
Yeah, dude. It's like you got all sad.
Yeah, I just didn't watch it because it was 8 o'clock at night trying to give me fucking bad dreams.
Dude, I'm getting sleepy right now, bro.
Why?
It's nighttime.
I know. It is hard to do this at night, but we will prevail. But, dude, if they put that shit out with human blood in it, miss me. Something's going on.
There's no human blood in it, dude.
How do you know?
Just to cut costs.
They might have
it. I mean, they need slaves to make these fucking sneakers, dude.
The blood's right there. It is just.
I mean, you can't blame the Q people.
Not even a little bit.
You know what I mean? Like that's why I get so heated. I get so heated because it's like, okay, man. Like there's that little diner I drive by where they're like, I can't remember what the fuck they say, but it's like, oh, it's batshit. QAnon is batshit crazy. Like they have that in the window. And every time I drive by it, I'm like, you don't even know about it.
Yeah.
Like, and fucking Lil Nas is coming out with that shit.
Yeah.
So what are you supposed to say? Like, if you don't know any of this, all you know of this whole culture is what you see on TV and on these, like, cue drops. Obviously, you're going to believe everyone in the music industry. I mean, Bieber said that he's sacrificed
kids. He touched his hat.
Yeah. I mean, come on, man.
Yeah. I mean, that is my main like jam up with people like, oh well, you're just like, you're too close-minded. You can't just let that be what it is. Like, I don't know, dude. Like,
there's been thousands of years of satanic ritual killings.
Yes.
Allegedly. Yeah. So yeah. I don't know if these are just nasty rumors. Who knows?
They might be, but
I want to know why the rumors exist.
It's just a weird shoe to fucking let out. I mean, at the end of the day, dude, Satanism's just gay.
So gay. I mean,
being that evil, it's like, okay, dude, you're so bad. You cut yourself and pray over it. Ooh.
It's weird, dude. I'm reading the Brave New World book, and it's everything that happened. Like, everything that's happening is in the book.
Who wrote Brave New World?
Sexualizing the kids, Aldous Huxley.
Okay.
They're like,
yeah,
sexualizing the kids. That's like the whole point of it. You're supposed to be promiscuous. That's like a trait that they thumbs up. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, this is why they fucking put Atlantis under the water, dude. They just fall into this debauchery, dude. I just don't understand the push for it.
Yeah, well, you know, in that book, it's like the kids should explore their sexuality. It's kind of crazy to hold that back from them, just like I've been saying to you. And, like, you're supposed to share. Everyone's supposed to be shared. You're supposed to be shared socially, like, you know. So, and then they breed different classes of people. It's pretty crazy. You should read the book. It's pretty cool.
I mean, that's disgusting, dude.
What?
That's disgusting. Like, I don't want to believe in
anything. They have, like, the betas are just for partying. There's, like, alphas and there's betas. Like, they make hot beta girls, and they're just out partying all night. Just
what do the alphas do?
Open for business.
What do the alphas do?
Pretty much control society and stuff.
Goon?
Yeah.
Just general goons.
Yeah, they pretty much just bros.
Yeah. I mean, I was pretty surprised by the – so far, I'm almost done episode 4. But that QAnon show really isn't that bad.
I know. I was afraid to turn it on because I was like, this is going to hurt.
Yeah.
This is going to hurt me. This is going to make me take down my Where We Go When We Go All sticker.
You have 3 stickers in your garage. Please, for the love of God. For Q, dude.
I'm not getting rid of the rabbit off. One.
No.
I'm not getting rid of the rabbit one.
Keep them all, but just never pop off, because if someone goes in your garage, the whole thing's fucked.
It is crazy, though, in the show when they start. Remember when we were like, holy shit, check this out. And then it changed and it got all bad.
Yes.
Like, they show that in the series.
That's what, right when all it was the drops. And I remember vividly driving around to a Pizzagate video just in my truck. And like, I was hitting bumps in my truck and my rock form was kind of fucked up. So it kept disconnecting and it would be like an Incomet ping pong, which is directly across the street from Haiti. And it just popped out. Yeah. I'm driving like, dude, holy fuck.
I used to walk my dog in the park around all those trans folks and stuff, and like I would hear that little bloop from the app.
Oh yeah,
and
I'd be like, drop.
These guys don't even know
TikTok, motherfuckers. Yeah, I mean, that was just fucking fun, and then you would watch this. Q drop happened after Pizzagate, right?
Yeah,
we watched the Pizzagate videos, and then the Q drop started happening.
I was doing Lewis arms when they fucking said it might be Bannon. Oh. I was like on my couch last night, being like,
"Yeah, they're on a few people, and we'll get to that in a second. I don't know if I have problems with the guy, but maybe I just hate him because he's me. I have no idea. But like, dude, driving along, getting the Q drops, like just learning about shit. It was sweet. You kind of figure some shit out, and then out of nowhere, you get all these fucking channels. It's like, okay. Who the fuck are you guys all profiting off of this?
Yeah.
Getting very weird. Selling VPNs. Ketogenic diet plans.
Gold. Trump gold coins.
Invest in gold. Like, all that shit just, it got completely ruined.
Yeah, it was pretty beat.
And now I'm watching, like, how stupid could I be? Just sitting there looking at the ground like, you're an idiot.
That's not that bad.
It's not the end of the world, but I mean, I was on record saying John Podesta was going to get arrested 2 Easters ago, and it never happened.
Hey, man.
Maybe he meant next Easter.
Sure.
Yeah, but, I mean, that is insane, but I...
Still no explanation, though, of the emails, of the weird shit.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's all.
I mean, they're just... All that stuff is just, oh, yeah, it's been debunked. By what?
Yeah.
Why is Beyond Borders across the street from fucking Comet Ping Pong?
Don't know, bruv. Never been in D.C., bruv.
Yeah, I don't trust it all, but Jesus Christ, is Jim Watkins not the biggest alpha on the planet? That guy.
I told you he was you, dude.
Yeah, I mean.
He loves the drip.
you're saying this, but obviously this morning I called you and said, you're Jim Watkins.
But you had no idea what you were saying.
You said reversal. I'm Jim Watkins.
It's just, it's a complete reversal. That dude, you have, he has your energy.
Yeah. That dude is a goon.
Yeah. Told his son to fall back.
That guy just reeks the high heaven. Like, something's up with that guy.
He's a fucking pedophile, dude.
You think?
Probably.
Is that who they came out as? Yeah. Oh, this is Q. He's a pedophile?
Yeah.
Yeah, that would make sense.
He's got the vibe. He's got that Kinka vibe, and he had the gay porn site, and Bucky he had man. Yeah, hilarious. Dude. It's a great show. I mean, I'm pumped at the show.
I'm very confused as to how.
I love
how,
that unit. I'm obviously Fred.
Yeah, I don't understand how they're like, why or how they're putting out like the Christchurch shit and the pictures and the comments. It's like, dude, like. People that don't know about this would be like, what? Oh, yeah. How do I get on 8chan? Yeah, I mean, that is just this, like, they're the some of the funniest pictures they're just throwing up real quick, like the 4chan Joe and stuff. And it's like, you guys are going to get people to, like, look into this stuff. You know that, right?
Yeah.
I'm very apprehensive about where it's going to go. Because right now, everything seems, like, very chill. I'm like, all right, this is fucking cool. And I'm just waiting for them to turn around and just go, boom. Shoot me right in the fucking head.
How you mean?
Like, I'm waiting for something to happen when they turn around and go, and if you believed all this, you fucking idiot. Yeah,
whatever.
I don't trust any. HBO has no reason to be doing some, like, straight fucking shooter thing on this where it's like not good or bad. It's like you got Generations, you got all these shows, then you're gonna give me a right down the middle Q documentary. Something's coming.
Yeah, I don't know. It's probably like definitely connected to some kind of intelligence because they would have shut it down.
Oh yes,
you know what I mean.
They wouldn't even have paid attention to it, dude. There's millions of things that are
painted the Frenchman's today.
Yeah,
we got to talking
about what
January 6th.
What do you mean?
It's not what it appears to have been.
Explain.
The morning of that, the morning of January 6th, the insurrection, Hong Kong, the Chinese went through Hong Kong and arrested all their dissidents. And they knew that it was going to be a rowdy day. And they were, his theory is that they were tired of Trump. The FBI was told to stand down.
Yes, obviously.
And the media just ran it for a week, and no one covered a thing in the world. Nobody covered a thing about Hong Kong.
Oh, they rounded up all the people that were protesting and shit?
All of the high-up political dissidents in Hong Kong against China.
Holy fuck.
They used the 6 because they knew it was going to be a bad day. And his theory is that they are powerful enough to get the media and tell the FBI. Yeah, tell the FBI to fucking stand down. That's coming from him, dude.
That makes complete fucking sense.
Yeah.
I mean, the fact that they just let everyone in there, and it was covered like it was 9/11, and it just wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
Fucking smokescreen. This shit happens every fucking time.
Yeah. We could talk about global affairs if you want.
I mean,
you're talking about the Suez Canal.
You're a boatman right now.
You want to talk about Suez Canal? Because
you might as well become a tugboat.
All right. I got way into boats, hogging, hilarious. but something that you might be interested in is we can't have this happen again, obviously.
Yeah.
There's another Gulf.
Really? Was it located in the Middle East?
Yeah. There's another canal they could make that they've been pushing for since the 60s.
No way. Get out of here.
Yeah. You wouldn't believe it. They're probably going to go through with it now after that debacle. It's going to be great for the world because it's going to lower the price that Egypt's been paying. Egypt's been getting like $27 billion out of this thing.
What do you mean? Like taxes?
Of tolls.
Oh, so Egypt's getting too much money.
Yeah. So there's right next door, there's another, they're going to make another canal. So that's pretty cool.
Double the speed. That's efficient.
Yeah. Just another alternative.
Yeah, I mean,
it's going to be great for like political positioning.
Motherfucker, dude. Yeah, that whole boat crash made zero fucking sense.
Does now.
I mean, yeah, obviously. And then watching them try to dig it out, it's just like, come on, guys. Like, how the fuck are you going to dig that out with one excavator? And I honestly couldn't even figure out how big of an excavator that was because it was next to a fucking mega ship.
Yeah, it's probably huge.
But Jesus Christ, like,
Everything holds 20,000 shipping containers.
Didn't something else happen with that dude? I think the guy running that boat ran into like a ferry too in the Suez Canal.
Maybe. They're over. All those dudes are overworked. And if they weren't paying attention, they could have totally been fucking around. And the wind blows.
Easily.
And once it goes, dude, it's if you're not watching it, it's tough to stop that momentum.
Yeah, I see that. Like, we do dumpsters down in Chester for the tugboat company. They come off, dude, and they look like pirates. Like, they're so fucking tired.
Yeah, they're overworked as fuck.
I mean, no shit that you can get people to, like, human traffic in overseas containers. Slip someone a few extra, like, 10, 20 Gs.
Those they don't guys inspect any of them.
Yeah, it's impossible.
Yeah, they don't. I mean, they literally don't inspect. Like, in China, there's only 4 inspectors.
Holy fuck. And yeah. I think there's something that's it's either in America or China, like where the dude, where the Chinese ones just like don't get inspected.
Sorry, what?
Dude, you're cracking it. What happened with Guinnesses? Why is it Guinness now?
I don't know. I had a bunch of Guinness over the weekend. I didn't get hungover, so I'm just gonna keep going with it until I get a wicked hangover.
I've done that before with Bud Light. What? I drank Bud Light like 3 weekends in a row. I mean, this is just a beer that doesn't get me hungover.
Exactly.
Then I
that's what I'm doing.
Threw
right
up outside my house like a bitch. That is, I at this point, dude. If someone can make something that literally will get me not hangover, I'll take it. But that's the only reason I don't drink.
Yeah.
I don't know how people do that.
They build up a tolerance, then they don't get hungover.
Bro.
Yeah.
But the road to that tolerance has to be hell.
It's 6 beers a night.
That's it?
Yeah, just keep going. 6 pack a night, build it up.
Then you wake up, and at what point do you have to consume the next 6?
I don't know. It depends on how you want to do it. I mean, you could start, if you drank every day after work, within a couple months, dude, you'd be almost unstoppable.
I'm good. I'll stick to seltzers. Yeah, the feeling, dude, I just hate that so much.
Yeah, everyone does.
Dude. The queasy tum, the headache.
Nobody likes it.
The loneliness.
Don't get me started on that, dude. I haven't slept. Nighttime is hard right now.
Why?
I just miss them and stuff. And I'm all by myself.
Obviously,
I'm like looking at pictures and stuff from a long time ago. This is dark stuff. Very bad.
Definitely
it's very bad. Let's not bring it down any harder, man.
Yeah, it's nighttime.
We don't have to talk about it.
We don't have to get sad and scary.
It's just kind of like, what would my life have been like, you know?
Honestly, probably not that good.
You think it would have been bad?
I think so.
Yeah, okay.
I think a guy like you getting tied down by something you don't want to be in, I think you would crab swirl even harder.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
I mean, that's a fucking definite.
I've come a long way, so I don't remember. Like, so, I've come such a long way from, like, all 5 years ago.
Yeah.
When I had a girlfriend.
Yeah.
And then I think about
who's counting?
I'm not going to 5, 6. Yeah. Whatever. And then I lay in bed, and I'm like, I'll be like, oh, wow, well, you know.
Sure.
I'll look it up. I'll look up pictures.
Yeah, I don't know how you do that. I don't ever look up pictures of old girlfriends or anything like that.
Yeah, well, it's different for me.
Obviously.
So.
Yeah, I mean, I think.
I'm all alone, man.
The way you're built. I think there's a white pill just floating out in the ether right now. I think if you were trapped in a marriage with someone that you did not love and the way your brain works, I don't think you'd be in a better spot than you are right now.
Yeah, I don't know. I just, in my head, I'm like, I would have grown into it.
And sure wouldn't have, dude.
I was in a bad spot. You know what I mean? I do this shit in my head. I'm like, I was in a real bad spot back then. Now that everything's going better, I can chill a little harder. Like, I probably wouldn't have been that high strung.
Yeah.
You know?
But then you would need them to stay the same age.
What
because,
do you mean?
Because they get older and they get meaner. Yeah, I definitely. For the most part, whenever I start thinking about that stuff, it's just that's just euphoric recall. And if you can block some of that shit out,
I'm trying, man.
Eventually, you just go, oh, yeah, that happened. Fuck. Oh, I hate that so much. I don't mind.
So at this point, like, I'm gone. Like, I don't remember any of the bad stuff. I like really have to try now to remember anything bad.
Yeah. I mean, it is very difficult.
It's just right now. It's just all the sad that I couldn't have given that chick a baby.
Dude, obviously, chill.
Sorry, man. You're not really talking about anything, dude. I don't know what to talk about. It's nighttime. You got a whole different fucking vibe going on in here, man. Yeah. I'm just showing up. You're watching Godzilla downstairs, man.
Yeah. I'm sorry. We can go
just pick up the pace, dude. Yeah. We're trying to do a podcast.
I'm sorry. You're under the influence.
Keep pumping me with beers, dude. I got seltz. Yeah.
Yeah, I was just jammed up by all that fucking Frisian shit that I was watching.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I don't know why, like, that is taboo. Like, why is that so bad?
What?
Why do people, like, oh, that's, like, there's a lot of fucking...
Oh, they say that it's a fake book.
Thor Linda?
Yeah.
And people call it cringe?
I found that because... Remember when I was, like, poetry's cool?
Yeah.
That dude that has that channel reads a poem.
Really?
Yeah. The poem that I liked, If, from Kipling. I was like, this is cool.
Okay.
And that's one of his videos.
Yeah, I mean, it's just crazy how all that shit just gets fucking pushed under the rug. Those are epic fucking tales.
Yeah, man. Pretty cool.
I mean, you like...
And it is a culture. Wheel of Time's real.
Yeah.
You know, Frisian's real. Check out Blade Runner.
Yeah,
dude,
I mean...
That dude's Frisian.
All the Germanic war with the Spartans, my favorite part about any of that, if they were big enough bros, the guys would just be like, all right, dude, we all kill each other, but you're cool as fuck.
Obviously.
I'm cool as fuck. Let's just chill.
Yeah.
And then you get... Then that creates Spartans.
Yeah.
All time bros. that whole story
was just about the bros chilling, dude.
That's just how it should be.
Yeah.
The girls should go off to school and learn how to dance and learn how to tease the boys.
They do this thing where they call the cows home and they sing.
The girls?
Yeah, the gals.
Yeah, I mean... All that, like, the Frisians, the Sumerians, what's the other ones? The bands, the L?
The Lemurians?
Lemurians, yeah, dude. Like,
Lemuria?
All this stuff.
Dude,
is,
so that shit is, like, underneath the ocean.
Yeah.
Underneath India. And the fishermen were getting their nets caught on it.
Oh, that's the shit Graham Hancock
that's
was talking
Lemuria,
about.
That's Lemuria, dude.
Dude.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I honestly, God, think, like, someone knows something. And they don't want us to know what happened in the past.
Yeah, it's the Atlantean deep state.
What?
It's the Atlantean deep state, dude. They worship Saturn. They do blood sacrifice.
Right on. Yeah. Okay, loud and clear.
Where
on
you
that.
Been, bud?
Yeah, that was just a fucking... I was driving. I felt like I was in another world just driving down the road listening to that. Like, dude, this is like...
Yeah, listen to it all the time.
This is as cool as things get. And it's kind of fucked up that they bombed... What's that island called? Heliglog?
Yeah, it makes you wonder. Makes you wonder why they when they fight wars, like apparently they went to, like when we went to Iraq,
yeah,
a bunch of countries went with us, and they just started protecting weird areas. And the soldiers were like, dude, what the fuck are we doing here? Like, it's not strategic at all. There could be, like, buried pyramids, stargates, who the fuck knows? Like, I didn't know Afghanistan had those giant sculptures.
Statues? Those things are fucking insane. Yeah, that's like, after watching that, at the end of the day, it just seems like everyone on this planet just kind of respects each other and wants to chill. And there's some weird elite ruling class who's constantly putting people to war to tear down whoever they don't like.
I don't know, man. Maybe.
I mean, that's
I hear what you're saying.
It's fucking
it's definitely
crazy.
A possibility.
Like, every single one of these wars make zero fucking sense.
Well, they're for banks.
Yeah, I mean, chill with the bank shit.
Yeah.
Why can't we?
Bankers.
We can all just chill, not do any of the dumb stuff, build sick ass shit.
Yeah, the Frenchman was telling me today, like, J.P. Morgan was British. So, like, that it was a house. Like, J.P. Morgan was like a market, like a house, like a fucking sort of like a S&P 500, I guess, or whatever, like that.
Yeah.
But they were just British dudes. But the whole, it's a British house, he said. There's also another one, the Dutch. They had their own thing going on called, like, the Hope House. And, like, it's just, like, the Dutch version of the Rothschilds. Like,
really?
There's just these dudes. Yeah, there's just these kind of dudes always manipulating markets. Like, this is just what it is. He's like, I asked him about all the World Economic Forum shit.
What'd he say?
He was like, it's all propaganda. He said it's 100%. All bullshit. Yeah, and then they flew him out to Vail, Colorado to, like, grill him, billionaires, to, like, fucking get in his face about stuff.
Grill the French?
Yeah, and he was like, all right, you're going to put me up. So he brought Bay, 3-day spa trip, goat.
Damn.
Dude's alpha as fuck.
I mean, it is weird that, like,
came down today and was like, I love having you here. You're good karma. I was like, fuck it, bro.
Fuck yes, dude. Yeah, I mean, all those World Economic Forum, everything on that level of content is so, like, it makes you feel gross.
Yeah, he was like, do you know Bernays? And I was like, yeah, yeah. Come and on. I was so proud. Oh, you know, yes. I was like, yeah, oh, yeah, I know. Dude.
What do you want to talk about? I'm smart, too. Yeah, I mean, the podcasts that are up there, the World Economic Forum, all that stuff, all the noises, all the, like, background stuff is just a hard, it gives you a horrible fucking feeling.
He was telling me, like, the percentage of facts to bullshit is out of control right now.
Just in general?
Yeah. Yeah. I asked him about China. He said eventually their economy has to slow down. So they have a Ponzi scheme going right now or whatever.
Yeah.
But, like, eventually the ball is going to drop. Like, their shit's going to slow down. It just happens to everybody.
I mean, there's no way they can keep it up building ghost cities for nothing.
But right now, their growth rate's so good, no one's going to stop investing in them.
Because people are just making money.
But I asked him, I was like, yeah, what about, is America and Europe still, like, way above them? And he was like, oh, yeah.
Yeah, there's no
And I was like, America and Europe's, like, friends, right? And he was like, sort of.
Yeah.
And he was telling me Europe's fucked. They're on full lockdown now because they did not pay enough to the fucking big pharma. So obviously. They went cheap on the vaccines.
Yeah.
So they're doing a whole lockdown again. They're rioting in Britain. The school kids are rioting in England.
Good.
And, you know, he said, like, it's fucking complete bullshit in France. Like, to get the vaccine, they're making all the elderly people wait in line. And I mean, dude, you're going to get sick.
Yeah.
You're going to get sick.
None of it makes sense. Like, once I heard that No Agenda clip of them talking, I think it was Argentina, like, you have to put military bases collateral. It's like, yeah. Oh, fuck.
Are they the guys that did the insurance thing, or was that Chile? Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I think it was either Argentina or Chile, somewhere around there. And it's just like, dude, you're a fucking pharmaceutical company. Fuck you going to do with a military base? Like, what is this?
I mean, you drop cans for Merck.
That was nuts.
I'm just saying, that's the level of... It's like Boeing, dude.
They're holding a gun to your head saying, like, take this or we're just going to lock you down again.
They're part of the military-industrial complex because they get vaccines. So, like, when they pushed that, I think it was called, like, it was, like, Crimson Winter or something. I got to look it back up. It was the first Dark Winter was 2001's anthrax vaccine.
Oh, and yeah, when they get fucked up from that.
Yeah, and that was Rumsfeld. When they get when the big pharma gets a contract, they're basically part of the military. They roll in there as a subcontractor for the military.
And just give everyone it.
So, their level of operation is up there in the MIC stuff. So, like, when you're dropping cans at Merck and stuff, it's like, dude, you're pretty much military.
Yeah, it feels like you know what I mean? Go in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean.
They're holding down corporate secrets, too.
Big time.
The corporate espionage that goes on, that's what I thought that Suez Canal thing was.
What?
I thought it was like companies starting shit, trying to create like a shortage. Yeah,
there was probably a lot of shit going on there that we have no
idea. I didn't realize that since the 1960s, Israel wanted their own canal. And they had a thing with the U.S. that they were going to use 520 nukes to make it.
Bro. Who comes up with these ideas?
Back in the day, they were freewheeling like the with 50s? Nukes. Back in the 50s and 60s, they were like dropping nukes like it was nothing, dude.
I mean, yes, I guess. Like, yeah, it makes sense. Just have a fucking radioactive cesspool that's a port.
Yeah, they were going to go 520 nukes, make a canal, and then Israel was going to control that canal on the east.
Yeah.
And then Egypt would have the West one, then that would create like a market, like a price.
Oh my God.
You know how they roll over there?
Yeah.
So.
That whole Suez Canal thing just reeks of like some sort of Middle East weirdness. Hold on one sec. Yeah, the amount of tomfoolery that's going on with, like, the advertising from the vaccines and, like, them just pretty much at this point putting a gun to your head, like, if you don't take this, you're kind of fucked. You know that, right?
Yeah, I think what they're going to do is, okay, hang tight for a second.
Okay.
What I think they're going to do is...
Excuse me.
They're going to... They're going to get everybody to start taking the vaccines. They're going to normalize that. They're going to normalize the vaccine cards.
Yeah.
It's going to take a while. They're going to, that's going to basically get rid of HIPAA as like old timey stuff.
Yeah.
So then what is the one industry that has not been able to collect data?
Who?
The big pharma healthcare industry. Because
like insurance?
That data is private.
Right.
So all the other shit on the internet has been fair game. And then
it's not even money would, at that point, dude.
Well, what? That's what I'm saying. They were pushing for this open vaccine, no privatized stuff in Europe. They were pushing for this a while ago. But if you think about it, it's like that's a way for them to open up customized medicine.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not done.
Oh, fuck.
Customized man. Medicine, right?
You come up with this yourself?
Yeah.
What are you, a psycho?
So it's like they want to customize medicine to you, right? But then what do they want to do whenever they want to like sell you something? They'll create supply and demand.
Yeah.
So there's also people that are buying up all the clean water. Well, in my head, that means that they're about to poison the regular water. Where like once they have your, once your shit is all public on your card, they'll be like, oh, well, it would be really easy to tell him that he needs this.
Yeah. They'd
make you sick with something easy. And it'll be like that. It'll be like, you're going to be on a ton of shit. People are on a ton of shit already.
Oh, yes, dude.
You know what I mean? Like, and they are allowed to have the commercials in America. America's the biggest market for this. The only thing that they're really lacking with the rest of the world with the internet is the collection of all this data.
Yeah, I think them getting a hold of everyone's shit, and that even makes it even better for them as insurance companies. Like, if you're, like, a fucking mess, and they can
see you. If I'm, like, an anti-vaxxer, they're like, we're not insuring you, dude.
Or you're just a sick person. It's like, why would we take you on? You're an absolute risk. Give me someone with
a It would be beyond pre-existing condition, yeah.
This is fucked. Yeah.
They'll create pre-existing conditions, basically.
Yeah.
They'll have your, you'll just have a card. You'll have a medical card that, like, will be out in the open. It's complete dystopia shit. It's Brave New World.
Yeah.
It's fucking 1984.
They'll have so much data on you. They'll be telling you like, oh, well, this is how you're going to live forever. Do this, this, and this. Like, oops, got cancer. Sorry.
Yeah, so this is where I could see a separation in the United States. I could see a breakup of the U.S. Because if Europe goes along with this, that'll be a whole fucking huge economy.
Yeah.
Then there's going to be parts of America. Right now they're legalizing weed in a panic button to get all the money back in all these states. So like New York just did it today. Like,
did they
New
really?
Jersey did it. Yeah. Hilarious. PA is going to do it. So like they need money so bad. If big pharma can promise, if you make this shit mandatory, we can really go into your state and really make some shit happen.
Build a few
buildings. I guarantee
you
governors are going to go for it. But then there's other governors that'll be like, well, shit, there's going to be a ton of people that won't go for this.
Yeah.
And will be for them.
I mean, Florida's doing it right now.
Yeah. So I could see like them breaking up, kind of like having so many different rules, it's almost a different constitution.
Yeah.
Because it's not constitutional to have this shit.
I mean, it's not constitutional to request someone's fucking like personal information, not let them do something because of something they did or didn't take.
Yeah, but I know that the HIPAA thing, you know, I could definitely see them phasing that out, you know.
They want to. It's like weird how bad they want to get up in your shit.
Not like really, they're a business, dude.
Yeah, but so are we.
Well, like if you do like the R&D for a vaccine, and then you have success with it, and then after a while it kind of becomes public domain, the shit's pennies.
Yeah.
What are you gonna do now? You're curing all this shit. What are you gonna do?
Make new ones.
You gotta make some new shit up. Yeah, now we got variants.
Yeah, I mean that's why I don't trust the Moderna coming out with one, because like you're a cancer company.
They went up $10 today on the stock market.
And everyone's probably tickled pink.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's just disgusting. There's people who are losing their skin over these vaccines, literally.
There's people I was talking to French about fucking, he was crying about the mental health. He said it's Bezos over in fucking Switzerland going nuts.
What do you mean?
She's stuck over in fucking Europe.
Oh, going, she can't leave?
Yeah, and it's like, it's all on lockdown. Europe's on lockdown.
It's the worst thing possible if you're sick.
Like, at this point, the economic damage and the mental health damage globally has been worse than
1 trillion percent.
I'm sorry.
Than the
I'm
thing sorry that people call COVID-19.
Sorry that your meemaw died.
Yeah.
Apologies.
Yeah, I mean, people get like pissed off and all this shit. Like, dude, it blows when people die. It fucking sucks. You know what sucks even more? When they die and something could have happened if everything was just running normal.
They were like, there was like some beef down in, was it, where's your boy Bolsonaro, Brazil?
Brazil.
There was some beef down there. He just fucking redid the whole cabinet.
Yeah, obviously.
He was like, nah, you're gone. Leave, blah, blah, blah. Like, put in a cop that he knows.
Yeah.
As some, like,
the dude has the ultimate shit. Masks are for fags.
He took his chief of staff and he just made him the head of defense.
This is how it should be operated. Definitely not a bunch of weird companies that pump a ton of money into the government and call the shots. That, like, the media has obviously been lying. If you believe in coronavirus and the whole 500,000, cool. But you also watch the news, and you can tell how they're lying about everything. World Economic Forum, supposed to be trusted, lying about everything. They're lying about absolutely fucking everything.
Well, they want a whole shift in the whole way the world works.
Yeah, but the only thing they're not lying about is the one that's the most profitable, K. Wipe the crusties out of your eye, buddy. They're lying to you about all of this stuff. They're not trying to save your life. The fucking people who invented OxyContin weren't trying to help people not hurt anymore. They're trying to make a fuck ton of money and not get sued in the process.
Yeah, it's crazy. The insurance that they're running is high.
For what?
It's like all the stock markets and all the insurance companies, like, they're making a fortune. Like, the what they're doing is, like, they separate the actuaries and the insurance companies.
Yeah.
The heads of the companies, they go like, oh, if anything goes wrong, it's on them. They make
on the actuaries?
Well, that's what they do. Like, they blame the company themselves, like, it's not in-house. It was them. They're the ones that messed up. God. Yeah.
I mean, this is literally Enron shit where it's like, we're Pfizer. We're guaranteed this much money, so we pretty much have it. Pump our value up. Thanks a lot, guys. And these guys are just making an assload of money off promised money. It's the most fugazi shit on the fucking planet.
Yeah.
And then people are going to Krispy Kreme afterwards like, I can't even get sick anymore. It's like, congratulations, dude. You're a fucking bozo. Yeah. Still haven't got sick. So many people have a fucking target on my back. Please, once you get sick, you are fucked. Brother, I welcome it with open arms. I know where I'm from. Release, dude. I know where I'm from.
You know your history.
I know where I'm going back to if this all shuts down. Yeah, I mean, it is fucking sickening. My buddies fucking talk about it all the time. For health reasons.
Oh, your boys, McConnell is out there saying every Republican man should get his vaccine.
Yeah.
So that's your I don't know, your friends like him.
Yeah. I would drag Mitch McConnell by his gizzard and put him on a stake. Shout out Bannon. Theoretically. Obviously, as a joke. All these people just need a guy. I mean, even Matt Gaetz. Bro, obviously. You're in
what,
it.
What a comeback, dude.
You're in it with the FBI. Everyone knows that.
Freaking, that's top tier shit.
That's an
actually.
Now, I demand that the DOJ release the FBI files showing that I was in a sting operation. This, like, that Matt Gaetz got accused of sex trafficking because he flew somewhere allegedly with a 17-year-old minor. The way he was talking to Tucker Carlson, it's just like, hey, Tuck, remember that one time we went to dinner? Remember that chick? Okay, just saying. Tucker Carlson completely bitches. I have no idea what you're talking about. These dudes are all fucked. Like, they're saying they have pictures of me. Where? No pictures exist. Like, fucker, they all have pictures of you. What are you talking
about? Yeah, I wonder, man. I wonder what they really get into if you think about it.
Debauchery.
Yeah, well, I'm telling you, man.
They spilled a cup of Hermes.
I watched the John Wayne Gacy thing.
Yeah.
And he was a serial killer. Now, I'm not finished the series yet, but they're kind of saying, like, there's no way he did this by himself. He was very politically connected, and it's kind of like this might be what some people get into.
What exactly was he doing? Like, what was, like, the main thing? Was he eating the people?
No. He was having sex with them, tying them up. And he would feel like a god. He would feel powerful.
Yeah.
So he would, like, get a young boy, like a young, strapping, like, 16, 17-year-old boy. Yeah. Now, he was allegedly molested himself.
Right.
So you know how the cycle goes.
Two wrongs don't make it right, obviously.
But he would get like 16, 17-year-old dudes, hang out with them, let them come over.
Bro out,
give him some beers, put on some porn,
yeah.
Show him some wrestling moves, you know, nothing suspicious, and then put handcuffs on him.
As a joke.
Hog time.
Right.
You know, violate them.
Yep.
Then he would dig a hole in a crawl space under his house, and he had 33 bodies buried under his house.
Oh, my God.
But they say, like, he couldn't have done it alone, and he never ratted anybody out. No but, like, way. He was... In local politics, he was pretty powerful. He knew a lot of people in Chicago and stuff.
It's wild. Like, when you watch all the soft white underbellies and stuff, like, all the prostitute ones, all this shit. It's like...
It's the shit with Ed Rendell we were talking about.
Yeah, I was 16 years old, and it was nothing but judges and lawyers.
Like, John Wayne Gacy got busted, but he could have very well been part of something similar to the Athlete A, Sandusky type shit. I'm not saying that was different. That's fingering little girls.
Yeah.
But, I mean, those kind of dudes might get into partying that hard. You never fucking know, dude.
Well, that
everyone's got their kink.
If you want to call that a kink, sure.
I know.
Yeah, I mean, that shit just happened with Lima, the high security juvenile correction center. Those kids were getting corralled to get fucked.
Yeah, wherever there are children that are unsupervised and don't have anyone protecting them, predators will be attracted to this spot.
Yeah.
And then they will prey upon the children. This is why I don't trust any coaches. Because it's like, bro, you really care about kids playing sports?
Yeah, I understand.
I don't get that, man.
Maybe if your fucking kid's on the team.
If your kid's not on the team, I'm like, yo, man. I mean,
if your kid's not on the team, dude, please.
If your kid's not on the team, take a hike.
See the fucking door. Yeah, it is. It's annoying. Like, you have that shit. All those dudes are connected to politicians and stuff. Then you have stuff like QAnon, Pizzagate, the Great Awakening subreddit, the Pedogate subreddit.
Oh, that was great. Those that you're taking me back.
You delete, you ban Pedogate, and it's like, for what?
I'd probably say it's like libel and stuff.
Yeah, but there's so much slanderous shit that goes on the internet. Why do you always attack the dudes going after the pedophiles?
Yeah, it seems to be a pretty pro pedo area. You know what I mean? That part of the internet.
It just doesn't make any sense that, like, Instagram bans the hashtag. A hashtag, it's like, come on, dude. That's just a hashtag. It's not even a fucking page.
Man, if you could read the Brave New World, you'd understand, like, that idea of having the child sexuality stuff.
What year does it take place?
It's in the future.
Like, does it say or no?
I can't remember. I'm doing an audio.
Yeah.
It's sweet because it's the dude from... Do you remember Austin Powers, like the dude who was like his boss?
No. Oh yeah.
The guy from Logan's Run. He's the narrator, but it's good.
Yeah, I don't want to believe any of that stuff. I want to think all rich people are just rich and they can't be bothered.
I'm just saying from the tweets. Remember the James Gunn type tweets?
Yeah.
It could be a culture that is kind of like they feel like they're suppressed. Where
who?
It's okay.
Pedophiles?
I'm saying like they wouldn't consider themselves pedophiles.
Right.
They would consider themselves celebrating youthful sexuality.
Right on. But obviously not.
Hey, man, I'm just trying to figure it out.
Yeah, I mean...
You know, this whole shit about... I'll go downstairs, you're watching Godzilla with Millie Brown Bobby or whatever her name is.
Yeah.
And Drake's hitting her up, right?
They talk about dating.
Yeah. So that's not appropriate.
Nah.
So there's obviously a culture where this goes on.
Yeah, I mean, I just think it's, like, pretty cut and dry. Like, it's like, hey, why is your tongue always going fucking crazy? Why do you love going to wrestling? Oh, you have Down syndrome. Okay, that's a person with Down syndrome. It's not that deep. It's a person with Down syndrome. Hey, you want to fuck kids? You're a fucking pedophile. There's nothing else behind it. You're just a fucking pedophile.
Yeah.
It doesn't come from any repressed sexual urge. It's like you are sick in the head and you want to hurt little kids.
What I'm trying to say is I think that there's enough of them that don't think they're hurting.
There's way too many of them.
Yeah. I watched a documentary where the guy said that's the thing. What you don't realize is that they think that they're doing good, that what they're doing is right.
Yeah.
And if there's enough of them together, and they go to Hollywood, and they all make movies together, like Bryan Singer, all these fucking dudes. What, man? They had those pool parties with the boys. Yeah. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I mean, it all, it's... If I were,
I know Steve Bannon invested in that. I don't know that.
If I was a pedophile, obviously not. I love women who are of age. Emphasis on women. I make Hollywood. I go out there like, you know, it'd be cute. Shirley Temple. That'd even be cute. Oh my God, everyone loves her.
I mean, she was MK Ultra, but
yeah, let's start making tons of like child actors. And it just becomes a heaven for all the prettiest little kids, and you can just devour them.
Yeah, maybe literally. Who knows? I don't know what the fuck they get up to, but I'm just here. I've seen a lot of shit on the internet since I've got my internet phone.
Yeah. If you follow the dark powers, it usually leads to human sacrifice and cannibalism.
I don't know what you want me to say, man.
I don't know. I've been fucked up. When you go down the vaccine road and all this stuff, I just get fucking destroyed.
Okay. Well, let's.
It just push it's on
through that.
It's weird for people to sit there and like on the internet be like, you're dumb for believing this. Like, I don't know, dude. I don't give a fuck that you're getting the vaccine, but to turn around after it's been a six.
This is what I was trying to tell Ricky at the bar.
What?
When we were sitting at the bar in between the shower curtains. And I was like, dude, if you got his girlfriend super pro, she's a nurse.
Snowflake, dude. Say it.
Definitely believes in the freaking virus. Say it, dude.
Just call her Snowflake straight up.
So
between us guys, she's a snowflake.
So I was just saying, if I said before the pandemic that a bandana would stop, you know, a deadly virus, or that these shower curtains would stop the deadly virus.
You would be called a QAnon conspiracy theorist.
She would have laughed at me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And then, yeah, I mean, if you told her that.
Like, all of this is clown world. And that's why I think it's like a hot. There's another game being played that we don't know about that's all about, like, submission.
To and see you just, what point
it's like survival time where you're like, all right, man, I guess I have to survive this, see if I can get enough money to break free of this civilization, go live out in the woods. I mean, this is the shit I think about during the day.
I don't blame you. I mean, that is a very good observation you had where it's like, explain what is going on now with a straight face to someone 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Not even about like the weird gray area around the coronavirus. It's like, there is a real deadly disease killing so many people that we had to shut the whole world down. But we can go back out to eat. It's still there. But a hipster put up a really thin piece of plastic, probably not airtight, and we can eat because he did that.
And chuck on a couple of dust masks.
Yes.
You know, there's not – I'm just saying that it is crazy. It's clown world, and, like, every time they do this shit, they tell you, no, it's good, you're good, we got you. Like,
yeah.
Thank God you have these masks, because if you didn't wear these masks – and only the good people and the virtuous people are the ones that are trying to protect the rest of the people from getting sick.
The idiots, the mindless. You know what I mean? The mindless people.
That'll be a bad thing when the cards come out and you don't have one. That'll be a real bad, like, you know.
Very bad.
That'll be a scarlet letter, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, that is going to be tough. I'm going to have to forge it as a joke.
Yeah. Like, you if you have to go get a CDL, there's a chance that they could do that kind of stuff.
I got plans. I got plans.
They might in the future. I'm not saying right now, but they might normalize all this stuff so that your medical information would just be out in the open.
I mean, look how this isn't like an over a year thing. Like, what's that anti-vax movie?
What?
What's the anti-vax movie?
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's a movie about anti-vaxxers. It was Vax or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
How long ago was that?
2 years maybe?
Yeah, that was like 2-3 years ago. It's like, that's a weird movie about anti-vaxxers. And it's just like, it gets the ball rolling. And then like every now and then it's like, oh, you're not an anti-vaxxer, are you? It's like, oh, no, I just don't like this vaccine. And then you keep rolling that fucking snowball until the coronavirus
comes
I
mean,
out.
Dude, they're really pushing to get RFK Jr. out of the world right now.
I mean, they don't want that dude.
They don't want that. I mean, he's pretty harmful for them.
For them, yeah. But in general, I mean, he's not like, he's been saying the same shit forever.
That's pretty harmful.
Yeah, I guess.
You know
so.
What I mean? Like, he's not harmless.
I can't think evil.
Yeah, you got to think like you want to control, you want to open up an entire market where there's no more medical privacy. That's what I'm saying. Like,
that is
it's a trillion dollar industry, even if it's just vaccines. So even if they just say coronavirus, mandatory for some people, schools and stuff like this.
Unlimited like boosters.
Rutgers just did that.
Yeah.
So if they do that, and then if they get it to be seasonal,
yeah,
then it's at every Walgreens and CVS. So that's a whole trillion-dollar industry right there. But then that's only the big companies. That's not a whole big market shift. Like, we could get people so subjugated to us that they would give away their medical freedom. You already gave away all the rest of your freedom.
Yeah, for the greater good.
You already gave it all away. So it's like you gave away all your information to all these other industries, and Big Pharma's sitting there going, man, we're missing out, guys. How are we gonna spin this?
Yeah,
what would get them?
I don't understand
a worldwide pandemic, maybe.
I don't understand how they're doing that shit when Rutgers, when like this stuff isn't FDA approved.
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, if you're Rutgers and you go to Pfizer, and you're like, dude, we're down, we'll play. I guarantee you. They're getting
some. Oh, Rutgers is going to be floating with a fucking, what's that thing in Disneyland?
It could be
Disneyland?
Fucking 50 years. The yeah. Bullet. It could be 50 years, dude. We'll fund you for X amount. You know what I mean? Like, we're talking mega bucks.
Yeah.
And that's what I mean. Like, Harvard was doing this shit with the coronavirus. They had that Fort Detrick thing. They mailed it over to Wuhan. This is all cut and dry. Everyone fucking knows this.
Yeah.
Like, everyone knows this is all a fucking weird virus thing that they could have controlled at every step of the way. So it either got out of hand and it is really spreading and there are real variants.
Yeah.
But it's a little convenient that at the same time they have a marketing plan ready to roll out. The entire media is ready to play ball.
Yeah.
Movies. No one's asking questions. Everything's getting fucking shadow banned. They put Fauci in.
The guy with the number one body count on AIDS.
Exactly. A dude that already pumped up a failed drug.
A failed cancer drug.
Like, this is literally, they've already done this stuff. These people aren't that creative. They're just fucking greedy and evil.
Yeah, that's why I could easily see them trying to push for some, like, stack in the courts and shit like that, because you want as many people on your payroll in the courts as you possibly can.
Yeah.
And this isn't about fucking whether someone wants you to have guns or not. It's how profitable can one slave be?
Like, they just locked down the EU again, and it's like, is it because they went with AstraZeneca?
Probably.
It could just be that.
I mean,
and like that's how powerful Big Pharma is. Like, you don't know what the GDP of some of these countries really is. I know Germany's paid as fuck.
Yeah.
But like, you know, how much fucking money is Denmark bringing in as opposed to Pfizer?
Yeah.
But, you know, like, what I mean? Like, yeah, I don't know. I mean, maybe they're blowing them out of the water. I don't know.
It literally just seems like all these people are being strong-armed, and you can sit there and call us fucking kooks, call us whatever you want, but the state of Texas exists. The case numbers are down, lower than California, in complete lockdown. I'm not arguing with you anymore. If you feel that way, don't get mad at me. I'm not arguing with anyone anymore. Texas exists.
Yeah, well, I think it's just financial because they get federal help if they stay locked down.
Yes.
So they're obviously the states that needed money.
City of Philadelphia is not opening back up.
No.
Yeah. State of Pennsylvania, everything's going to open back up. The city needs a few more bucks because maybe they mismanaged it.
That's
somewhere.
All it is, yeah.
Maybe a little too much money went up into Overbrook.
Well, anywhere that's really greasy is just going to do this because it's free money for the politicians.
Yeah.
And when they get money, they can dish it out and then they get kickbacks.
Dude, the other thing, I think it was on No Agenda, they were Biden was going on and on and on about, we're going to make a fucking huge website. It's like, motherfucker.
Yeah, this is
you and the website.
He just forgets that he already did this. he had his son-in-law already do this.
For the Obamacare. It's like, yeah. You're going to do this. And that website,
I mean, Ryan
was,
Dawson's making a Biden crime family map.
Please.
Just like the Epstein one.
That was a billion-dollar website that he built?
I can't remember, but it was they had zero experience. They weren't on the internet. They rolled up to Obama. Obama gave them the contract. They put together a half-assed website. Obamacare never fucking worked.
No.
You know what I mean?
They're just fucking
everyone bitched about the website. That was Biden. I mean, the shit that Biden is connected to, like, you know, the corruption and stuff, is insane. The fact that they don't go into that, they don't go into his... That clip, dude. I mean, play that clip for the people.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to go grab a beer.
I'll try to find it.